arrived, we were in the middle of a losing streak. We had a young man named Brian Salter who was a running back for us. And as I was preparing to go in and give, you know, what all coaches give, their motivational speech prior to going out onto the field, Brian had already started talking and was emotionally invested in this particular football game. And so I just kind of assessed the situation, realized that all eyes were on Brian, and Brian was probably giving a better speech than I could ever possibly give. And we went out and beat Teal College that afternoon, a lot on Brian's individual performance in that game. And it was really a positive step for me in terms of the head football coach, seeing players actually take ownership of the program.
Lots of kids from Youngstown, and we just did, I think we did a great job bringing Ohio back into Oberlin College. And I think that's the thing that I'm happiest about that we did. Favorite times, I think upsetting Denison probably was the biggest win. And, you know, it was just a great football game. And Bill Kovach, who was an uncle of two other kids we had in the team. We had an uncle and two brothers on the team. Bill Kovach from Amherst caught the pass to win the game, and it was really a great game. My way of thinking, I don't think I could have had a better time than coaching at Oberlin College. Well, not just football, but coaching at Oberlin College and the kids we had and the people we had to work with.
Oberlin College, in educational terms, is one of the most highly regarded institutions in the nation, with its Division of Arts and Sciences and its nationally renowned Conservatory of Music. But there is nothing traditional or conservative about Oberlin College, because you see in its history our large two essential facts. It was the first co-educational institution in this country and the first white institution to admit black students. Now, something new is happening at Oberlin College, this time in the world of athletics.
Hey, this is Greg Mangan, Oberlin class of 2009 and current defensive assistant football coach at Stanford University. Congratulations to Oberlin football, 125 years of history. That's a lot of years of playing football. I'm here at Stanford and we're celebrating our 125th anniversary of the school being founded in 1891. And to think of Oberlin playing football for that amount of time, let alone being an institution of higher learning, it's really impressive. I'm very proud to be part of that tradition. I still keep in touch with all the guys that I played with at Oberlin, and we're always following how the team's doing, and we're very proud of our small part in building the tradition there and continuing a legacy of football that spanned well over a century, you know, from John Heisman on through. So just wanted to congratulate everyone there on 125 and definitely following the team closely and rooting for you guys. Go Yo!
all started for me back in Oberlin back in 1986, where I started my coaching profession there, and can't be more pleased and proud of being able to spend 5 years of my coaching career there, and started as a running backs coach and special teams coordinator for Don Hunsinger, who was a great boss and a great leader at the time, and he taught me a lot about this job, recruiting and how to handle young men. And I'd be remiss if I didn't say anything about the players that I first started coaching. I was their age, you know, I started at 22 years old, and such a tremendous respect for what those guys went through and all the things that we did from a practice schedule and trying to make those guys better. It's a great place. A lot of great people have come through there. I remember the deans and the president and all the financial aid director. All those people were such special people to me to work with in the football program, and I'm so proud to be from there, and they'll have many, many more years of great tradition at Oberlin College.
I'd like to start with thanking the Heisman Club for asking me to be a part of this celebration. But in reflection of my 15 years as head coach at Oberlin College, you know, with all the great guys that came through the program, all the people that I worked with, it was a wonderful, wonderful time of my life. But I think when you think of the wins and all the successes that we have and all the growth that took place, it goes along with all the people you meet. And there's one person in particular, and that's Jeff Blodgett, who was an art history professor, graduate of Oberlin College. You know, he's in the Hall of Fame. He's a guy that, as you all know, saved Oberlin football not once, but twice. And, he was in the stands when we broke the losing streak in 2001. He was in the last stages of his life. He was suffering from pancreatic cancer. And, Tim Carver came up to me and told me that he was in the stands, and I had no idea. And so after the game, the team came up and gave him the game ball, but the joy I saw in his face of watching us break that losing streak, and then to sadly watch his life end 2 weeks later, is a memory that will stay with me forever.
The tradition of Oberlin College football is something that I take seriously. Where this program is today would not be possible without the people who have come before me. We are continually investing each and every day to get better and live up to the standards the players and coaches have set for this program. Wearing the crimson and gold every Saturday is a privilege, and we will continue to strive to make new memories in our new home. Go, yo! Acceptance is here. The happy ones are near. Let's get together.